Good morning, I'm Dana Katz.
And I'm Randy Irich.
And this is the Friday, November 6th edition of the UPC Morning Show. The HOBY Selection Committee would like to congratulate Aaron O'Leary for being chosen the 1993 Countryside High School representative to the Hugh O'Brien Youth Foundation. Aaron will represent Countryside High School this spring at the state HOBY convention in Orlando, with the opportunity to represent the state at Ohio State University this summer. Congratulations, Aaron.
Attention, all junior varsity boys basketball players who are currently trying out for the JV team. Practice will start today at 4:30 for you. Any questions, ask Coach O'Neill.
Marine Biology Club members, if you did not pick up your November calendar, stop by F5. Also, SeaWorld is coming up Friday, December 4th. Cost is $15 and is open to all club members. Bring your money or checks to Mrs. Boylan in room F5.
A blood drive will be held for the benefit of Cliff Harris on Sunday, November 15th from 10 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. in the parking lot behind Grandy's on Curlew Road in U.S. 19. Cliff will be needing surgery and will require many pints of blood.
The following colleges will have representatives and guidance. Friday, that's today, University of Pennsylvania, 11:30. Get a pass from your counselor if you wish to attend.
Attention, all Spanish Club and Spanish National Honor Society students. Please bring in any things you have to donate to our garage sale table for the CHS flea market this Saturday. Bring your items to room K9.
Have you noticed a delicious aroma in the hallways lately? The DECA marketing class has been busy all week baking cookies. Due to heavy demand, they are temporarily sold out, but will be back on Tuesday.
Seniors, remember to order your graduation announcements on Thursday, November 12th, during lunch. Full payment due with your order. Make any checks payable to Harris Jones Company. Extra tassels will be available for $4 each on November 12th. Juniors and seniors, you still have a chance to order your class rings on November 12th. Also, the ring packets price lists are available in the main office. You will need a $50 deposit to order a class ring. Extra announcements are available in the guidance office.
The Spanish Club will meet on Tuesday, November 10th in K2, Mrs. Bravos' room at 2 o'clock.
Mr. McNeil would like to invite all students and faculty to attend the Art Harris Art Show at the Dunedin Fine Arts Center this Saturday and Sunday. Please speak to Paul Epling, the artist who is sculpting a cougar for the front of the school.
The Countryside Football Booster Club is sponsoring an exciting garage sale flea market this Saturday in the bus circle from 8 to 2 o'clock. There will also be an all-you-can-eat pancake breakfast in the cafeteria. Tickets can be purchased at the door, so everybody be there.
Let's go take a look at how the band did at their competition in Vero Beach last weekend.
This past Saturday, the Countryside Golden Cougar Marching Band went to the Vero Beach Treasure Coast Crown Jewel Band Competition. Let's see how they did.
I'd like to thank the color guard for the hard work, and even though the first time we didn't do so well, the second time we kicked butt.
The drum line did really well. We showed off our new drums, and brass did great, and the whole band as a whole really did good.
This past weekend was one of the greatest weekends of my life. I was very, very happy with the performance of our band. They did a spectacular job. They showed that they're hungry to get things done. And I love it.
I'd just like to say thank you to all the members of the Golden Cougar Marching Band and Mr. Hayward for a great performance and a very emotional day on Saturday. This has been Anthony Perulli for UPC.
As everyone should know, this week was Multicultural Week. Let's take a look at one student's attitude towards prejudicism. Prejudicism. Multicultural fairs.
Prejudice. We all need to ensure that we have a chance to learn about people we do not necessarily encounter in our everyday life. Because of our nature and race and relationship and interaction in America today, we do not know a lot about each other. All too often, we live in different neighborhoods, attend different schools, but the best way to learn about people is through personally interacting, feeling that you need to make sure you know something about the people and their history and contribution.
So how's your Halloween, Randy?
Oh, my Halloween was great. How about yours, Dana?
That was okay. It's too bad there's so many cops you couldn't even do anything.
Yeah, well, hopefully no one got in trouble and no one did anything wrong because, you know me, I don't do anything wrong, so I should be your example.
Okay. We just arrived in downtown Tampa, parked our car in a nice parking garage. We got off under the idea, we saw a little sign and it said, exit 25, bus to Guavuin. We have no idea where the bus to Guavuin is, but we're walking in general direction. Some people we saw before that told us something about like Marion Avenue,
something
I think they
like
said.
That.
Something like that. So here we go.
Cultural Club for their